Hi guys, I'm Michelle Wright with the Cow Whisperers CreativeCards.com and I'm an independent Stampin' Up! Demonstrator. Well, it's Friday and that means it's Tip Friday, and today we're going to be talking about sandwiches for our embossing folders. I know there's a little bit of confusion out there and I want to clear it up for you. So, first of all, let's get these embossing folders all out of the way. We're going to start with our platform. Just the platform that came with your die machine, your die cutting machine, okay? So right off the bat, let's talk about just a standard embossing folder, okay? Just a standard embossing folder. You're going to need a clear plate, and you know I recommend plates that you haven't die cut with, because that's just, it could transfer any cuts through, depends on how sensitive the actual embossing folder is. All right, so platform, clear plate, embossing folder with your cardstock in it. Always, always taking this edge that's got the fold in it, the bend in it, and running it through first. If you run it through this way, if you have to do that on occasion, okay, but if you routinely do that, the pressure from your machine can make this shift and pull, and eventually it will break this down. So I always recommend that you take the fold and run it through first. So let's do it again. Platform, acrylic plate, embossing folder with your cardstock, another acrylic plate. This is your standard embossing, okay? So we can move that. Now let's go to our dynamic embossing folders. These are the embossing folders that Stampin' Up! Sold that we actually purchased or ran through Sizzix. It will have Sizzix up here in the top left-hand corner. That's how you can tell the difference between the dynamic embossing folders and our new 3D. See, they both say stamping up here, but our new 3D do not say Sizzix in the top left-hand corner. Very important to notice that. So, we're going to talk about the old dynamic embossing folders, the thick ones. Same thing, you're going to run this through first, but you're going to use a Big Shot platform, your dynamic embossing folder with the cardstock in it, and only one plate. That's your sandwich. Run it through, okay? Platform, dynamic, plate. All right, we've got that done. Now, let's talk about our new 3D embossing folders. There's just a little bit of difference in depth. Same thing, platform. Running this edge through first. Does not say Sizzix. That's how you know this is a 3D. Put your cardstock in here. You're going to run it through. Can you use one acrylic plate like this? Yes. Chances are you're going to need to put some cardstock on here and shim it up. Okay. But yes, you can do that. You may need four or five layers and or play with it. Every die cutting machine is different. Remember that. The tension is going to be different based on how many times you've used it and so on. All right. What do I recommend? I recommend you buy our $10 embossing plate. $10. It's blue. Okay. It's made to work with the platform and the 3D embossing folders. So what's your sandwich? Big Shot platform, 3D embossing folder with your cardstock in it, and the blue plate, and you run it through. It's just that simple. Easiest and best $10 you'll ever spend. Then every time you grab one of these 3D folders that it just says Stampin' Up! On it, you know to grab the blue plate. There you go. I hope that helped clear up the embossing folder problems that people are having out there. And I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, please give me a thumbs up. If you live in the United States and you're looking for an independent Stampin' Up! Demonstrator, I would love to be your gal and sure appreciate your business. I've got this fabulous plate listed both in the I above or below in the description. You can click right on it to purchase it and make your embossing a whole lot easier. I would like to say I have two more videos at the end of this one that I think you may enjoy as well. So I hope you have a wonderful day and happy crafting.